As if it weren't enough that Germany and France are cooperating to build warplanes, they have now restarted the main ground combat system program, which aims to replace the Leopard 2 and Leclerc in 2035. If it is successfully developed and purchased by many countries in the EU, then the new generation of main tanks in EU countries may be unified, and it may be possible to get rid of excessive dependence on the United States in the field of defense. So what kind of tank is the MGCS? Germany and France have joined forces to build warplanes, tanks, a new self-propelled gun, and other equipment, not only for the future combat air system program but also for the early launch of the MGCS project. According to public information, the entire MGCS program can be roughly divided into three main stages. The program is currently in its first phase, and it is expected that the new tanks will be first deployed in 2035, with full operational capability by 2040. Meanwhile, in order to satisfy the interests of all parties, Germany and France have agreed to divide the work equally between the industries of the two countries and to reach an agreement on sharing the results. The MGCS will be competed for by KNDS and Rheinmetall, a holding company founded in 2015 by Germany's Krauss-Maffei Wegmann and France's Nexter. So what will this next generation main battle tank look like? Since the project is in its early stages, the final shape has not been finalized. But I still have a way of knowing what the MGCS will look like. Because the combat capability of a main battle tank is basically determined by the three main characteristics of firepower, protection, and mobility. So we can deduce the general look of the MGCS based on the tank technology of Germany and France. And both Rheinmetall and KNDS have shown concept models of the MGCS program, the KF-51 Panther and EMBT tanks, respectively. So it's even easier to speculate. The most notable thing about Rheinmetall's KF-51 is the 130mm tank gun, as well as one of the tank gun solutions for the MGCS program. The RH-130 smoothbore gun used in the KF-51 is the first tank gun with a caliber larger than 125mm, after the L-44 M256 120mm caliber smoothbore in the NATO system and the 2A46 M125mm caliber smoothbore in the Warsaw Pact system. Rheinmetall stated that the gun had a barrel length of 6.63 meters and weighed 3 tons. The muzzle velocity reaches 1,800 meters per second, 50 to 220 meters per second faster than that of the RH-120 smoothbore and 50% more powerful. The range will be longer than the 4 kilometers that the RH-120 had with the DM63. In tests, the RH-130 tank gun achieved a vertical penetration of 1,200 millimeters against homogeneous steel armor at a range of 2,000 meters. This far exceeds the 600 mm penetration of the current DM-63 series ammunition. Another tank gun option for the MGCS is the 140mm caliber Ascalon tank gun proposed by Next. According to publicly available information, Ascalon is an integrated gun system that includes a tank gun, recoil device, autoloader, and shell. The most important of these, the 140mm smoothbore gun, in addition to having a larger caliber, uses a very unique 140mm telescopic APF SDS, which not only uses the rare telescoped ammunition design but is also equipped with a corresponding guidance system. The overall length of the ammunition is 1.3 meters, which is shorter than the 1.5 meter long conventional layout APF SDS of the same caliber previously developed by France. Ascalon tank gun. In the firing of this ammunition, the muzzle kinetic energy is 20 MJ, with the ability to penetrate more than 1,300 mm of homogeneous steel plate at a distance of 2 km. In addition, due to the smaller overall size of the telescopic ammunition, it is easier to store and transport, with more ammunition in the same amount of space. While more key data on the Ascalon tank gun has yet to be revealed, Next promises that the technological solution on which the Ascalon is based will be fully mature by 2025. So which of these two tank guns is better suited for MGCS? If I had to choose, I'd definitely go for the larger caliber Ascalon weapon system. However, not all data on either the 130mm RH-130 or the 140mm Ascalon has been made public at this stage, so it is not possible to make an accurate judgment. And the MGCS program is still in its first phase. In case a more effective gun appears later, it may also be replaced. In addition to the large caliber tank gun, the MGCS design team has also fitted the tank with other advanced weapon systems. In the MGCS team's vision, directed energy weapons are expected to be installed to deal with armored vehicles equipped with reactive armor and APS. Vehicle-mounted launchers and loitering munitions will be installed to combat targets beyond visual range. The MGCS team has even reserved a place for a high-energy laser in order to better carry out anti-drone, air defense, and other missions. So which weapons will these be? In this regard, we can speculate with the help of the existing KF-51 and EMBT tanks. For example, when fighting beyond line-of-sight or non-line-of-sight targets, the MGCS could be fitted with a four-unit missile launcher like the KF-51, firing the Hero 120 portable anti-tank loitering system, which was jointly developed and manufactured by Israel and Germany. The missile has a range of 1 hour and a maximum range of 60 kilometers. The missile can be maneuvered by a drone operator and can also be used in conjunction with battlefield situational awareness. The warhead's explosive power is sufficient to destroy most small targets. The MGCS is equipped with a standard dual-channel infrared imaging viewer for the vehicle commander and gun commander, with multiple cameras around the vehicle to improve situational awareness. For anti-drone and air defense missions, the MGCS can be fitted with a 12.7mm machine gun, a 7.62mm anti-aircraft machine gun, and the new RCWS remote-controlled weapon station, just like the EMBT. In particular, the RCWS remote-controlled weapon station is fitted with an ARX 30-30mm cannon, which can deal with most low-flying fixed-wing fighters, helicopters, drones, or light-armored vehicles on the ground, in addition to combating high-positioned anti-tankers, which are common in urban warfare, and dramatically improve the MGCS tank's close combat performance. In terms of protection and maneuverability, we can likewise refer to existing tanks. The MGCS may continue to use the modified Leopard 2A6/A7 series tank chassis, just like the KF-51 and EMBT. The MGCS will optimize the frontal armor of the chassis by lowering the turret to reduce the area under fire. It will also continue the Leopard 2 series defense scheme of large inclined composite armor but should use lighter composite armor. This will increase the tank's mobility with the same level of protection. At the same time, the MGCS will be enhanced with active protection systems, such as the Israeli Trophy Active Protection System installed around the turret, the ELM-2133 Windguard Active Protection Radar, and the Enhanced Laser Warning System. Once an incoming anti-tank rocket or missile is detected, it can be intercepted by firing heat from MEFP launchers on either side of the turret. In general, when a high-speed object is detected, the system computer calculates the engagement data based on the information obtained and sends it to the MEFP launchers mounted on the sides of the vehicle. The MEFP fires heat, creating a very tight, precise matrix of fire to destroy the target. The MEFP is designed to have a very small kill zone so that it does not endanger personnel in the vicinity of the protected vehicle. It is capable of defending against incoming targets, including low-velocity armor-breaking rounds, man-portable rockets, and anti-tank missiles. Tank weight is an inescapable topic when it comes to mobility. With current main battle tanks, every new model and every new component added will affect overall transportability, speed, and maneuverability, including the ability to cross bridges or maneuver in urban terrain. And higher weights also increase fuel consumption, which can adversely affect range and lead to increased wear and tear on the drivetrain and travel mechanisms, making them less reliable and increasing maintenance costs. The EMBT weighs 61.5 tons, and the KF-51 weighs 59 tons, so the MGCS should weigh in at around 60 tons. Also, the MGCS team is working on reducing the crew size by using a two-man turret or even an unmanned turret to reduce the weight. Also, the MGCS will have a hybrid powertrain. Compared to traditional diesel power, a hybrid power unit can save 15-20% of fuel, and for some lighter main battle tanks, it can even improve fuel efficiency by 30%. The hybrid powertrain will also keep the engine under optimum load at all times, dramatically increasing efficiency and allowing the power mode to be switched at any time as needed. There is also a reliable electrical backup when the primary power source is compromised. Less noise and vibration than conventional power systems. Not only does it reduce logistical maintenance stress, but it also boasts lower acoustic and heat signatures as well as silent surveillance capabilities. It was revealed that instead of designing and building a separate main battle tank, the MGCS will be designed around the vehicle to create a family of heavy tracked combat vehicles for the army, including models such as main battle tanks, infantry fighting vehicles, and multi-purpose missile launchers. The MGCS will collaborate and network with a variety of external platforms, acting as a command center for various ground vehicles and unmanned aerial vehicles, thus developing new synergistic tactics. Overall, the main performance improvement of the MGCS tank is still in the direction of firepower. Although the MGCS is led by Germany and fully supported by France, other European countries have also expressed their willingness to join. The reason for international cooperation, on the one hand, is to gather the advanced technology of all parties to create the strongest four-generation tanks, on the other hand, it is to increase the production of tanks to reduce the development and production costs. The F-35 fighter jet is the best example. Only this mode of cooperation also brings a lot of problems, such as different countries on the tactical indicators of the requirements of different countries, national defense enterprises in the framework of the cooperation of the responsibility is unclear, the key technology research and development lags behind so that the project delays, etc., will lead to cooperation in research and development work in trouble. Therefore, Germany and France let KMW, Nexter, and Rheinmetall, the three major participating companies, set up a joint development team, and by virtue of Germany's strength as the leading developer, France is fully cooperative to avoid the above problems. This is what led to the present-day competition between KNDS and Rheinmetall. Of course, even if the MGCS is developed, it is still a big test to see if it can eventually be promoted. In addition to the technical cooperation issue, the MGCS is likely to affect the interests of the United States. If the European countries cannot resist the pressure and choose to purchase the US M1A2D main battle tanks, then the promotion of MGCS in Europe will become very troublesome. Overall, however, MGCS is the first complete European next-generation main battle tank program, and its technical development is worth looking forward to.